Hello, my name is Vesa Juvonen, and in this demonstration we will have a closer look on how you can actually brand your private mine sites and obviously the public mine sites or personal sites as well using the new SharePoint app pattern or the cloud application model. So without any server-side customizations or any feature framework elements, we can still apply branding elements to the private mine sites or personal sites as well. The only thing is that we need to kind of think through how the sites are provisioned, and we can either override the provisioning engine or we can automatically apply the branding to persons, my site from the intranet front page or any content pages within the intranet, or for example by placing a SharePoint app on the my site host. So whenever the user actually arrives on the my site host or the personal for the intranet, we will actually apply branding or updated branding on the personal side as well. First of all, let's have a look on the my site structure slightly more detailed. So first of all, we need to notice certain things. So the public my site host is usually hosted, for example, in the URL of mycontoso.com. And the key point of this one is that this is the root site collection of the application. It doesn't have to be a root, but it's a separate site collection anyway than your private my site or the SkyDrive Pro. So while we actually move across the newsfeed or about me, we are all the time actually working within the public my site host site. If we actually go to the SkyDrive Pro, then the URL is changing. So we're able to actually see that this is a completely separate URL, which is actually in the mycontoso.com/personal/administrator and so forth. So it's a separate site collection, which means that for every single end user and every single person within the farm or within the Office 365 who will have a SkyDrive Pro site, there will be a separate site collection applied. And in this particular case, this is actually a really good example. So in our public My Site host, we already have applied a custom branding using theming, which is slightly more maintainable or cost-friendlier approach than using a custom master pages. So that's the reason why we use theming in our demos. But as you can see in the public my site, we have a grayish, slightly modified branding. But then whenever the private my site has been applied or created, it has been applied and created using the out-of-the-box behavior and out-of-the-box look and feel. Obviously, it's really good if you don't need to change this and you're happy with the colors and all of that, but you can actually modify the branding of the private or personal sites pretty easily. And the whole model is actually based on the highly enhanced social client APIs. So let's actually have a look on the code. And while we're starting to have a look on the code, I'll start deploying the application at the same time so we can actually walk through what is actually then happening within our code. The code itself is a provider-hosted application or provider-hosted SharePoint app. In this case, it's running in my local IIS Express. It could be running in Windows Azure for the Office 365, or it could be running, well, virtually anywhere in the world or any hosting technology in the world. And the application is built in a way that the real full screen experience, it doesn't actually do anything. So I just only have a few notes here saying, with a few typos, saying what is it actually for and how it should be used. But then how do we actually use this, the personal, or how do we apply the branding is that we actually go to one site within the existing, let's say, tenant or in your intranet or deployment. A good example would be the private my site, the public my site host. Just as well, we could actually add this app part to a intranet front page if you would like to apply branding changes to people's personal sites from there. Now that the app has been deployed, we can actually take that app into a use in this public my site. So let's click add an app. And while we are adding app, we will get a list of app parts which are available. Not add an app, because we are actually editing the page and adding the, we already added the app using the Visual Studio. So let's edit the page and add a web part. Before we actually do that, this natively out of the box in the My Sites, this is the funky named web part, which is out of the box web part, which is actually the one which is taking care of the personal My Site creation. So if you would like to override that completely, the personal My Site creation, you can actually take get rid of this web part and then replace the personal My Site creation using your app part as well. So that's also supported in the social API, which is pretty cool. In my case, however, what I want to do is that I want to make sure that we apply the custom branding to the private My Site, but I want to take advantage of the out-of-the-box behavior. So that's the reason why I don't actually get rid of the web part. What I want to do is that I want to actually the SharePoint provision me a personal My Site or personal site, and then using this app I can apply whatever branding elements what I want on the personal My Site. So I'm adding the personal site customizer. Seems to be a few more other apps there as well. The app is installed and our code is actually executed. So how does these things actually now work? We're getting the SharePoint host URL, and as mentioned, this is a provider hosted app, so we're actually running outside of a SharePoint context again. So this is a app part which is pointing to this modified personal My Site, and then in the back, in the server side code of that ASP.NET application, we're actually doing the, let's say, magic of applying the branding to personal My Site. And for that, we're using the as mentioned, the social APIs. There's one trick, however, what we're doing here is that we're using the client context without the app authentication. And this is something which definitely is not available when you do app development for the marketplace. But if you do a custom app development for your customers or your own SharePoint deployment, you can approach these things slightly differently. And this actually gives us the benefit of ignoring the app permissions. What we do here is that we essentially take connection and using the client-side API using the old-school SharePoint 2010 way without OAuth. So we're only taking into account the user identity permissions. And that's kind of, in this case, this is a proof of concept, but that's there for ignoring or let's say avoiding additional permissions, because each user has permission directly to access the user profile and they can actually work with that. So we're kind of bypassing the app permission thing. So what we're doing here is that we're getting the user profile, we're loading the user profile, there's what an additional semicomma, not a meaningful one. We're taking the personal site site collection, or we're loading that. If that object wasn't there, we could actually provision. And what this would actually do is the exact same thing what the out-of-the-box web part, the funky named web part in the public My Site host would have been doing, is that it would schedule a personal site to be created for a particular user. There's actually a synchronous creation option available in the CSM API as well. Do you want to do this and override the out-of-the-box behavior? Probably not. So it's not necessarily something what you want to do, but what's actually more interesting is that you can place this app part now anywhere in the tenant or in this SharePoint farm, and this would actually work as long as that particular application has been associated to the same user profile service application. So when the site actually exists, we are able to modify the branding by applying a theme. Don't worry about the typos in the comments. You can probably understand what's meant to be written there anyway. So what we do here is that we actually take the URL of the site collection and we load the root web of the site collection. Let's actually walk through the code. There's the user profile, getting the site, loading the site, site collection, the personal site collection. The personal site collection already existed. So let's actually create a new context using the personal site URL, because the previous context is actually running in the host web context where the app was installed. And in here, we essentially take the root web of the site collection, and we apply a theme. Technically, the theme selection is not available in the private in the personal My Sites, but you can actually apply the theme programmatically. So the theming files are available there. Just as well, you could actually upload a custom master page, but that wouldn't be as cost efficient from a maintenance perspective. So let's move forward. We applied the theme, we execute the query, and eventually when the WCF calls end, in this particular case, we're just ugly writing something on the app part, which means that now the My Site has existed and the personal My Site has been customized. And this essentially would be now working against dynamically on that person's personal My Site who's accessing the public My Site host. And the key point here, what I already mentioned like 2 to 3 times, is that you can actually place this web app part anywhere within your tenant or within your SharePoint deployment, as long as it can figure out the user profile context. And that would still make the branding updated on the personal My Site using the cloud application model. So now if we go to the SkyTrack Pro, which is the personal My Site, we're able to see that the branding, the theming, the coloring has been applied within the private My Sites. Again, the key point also is that we're using the cloud application model. So I can actually now update this branding or the code or the behavior without deploying, without the need of service breaks, without any need of deploying actually any code on a SharePoint servers. The whole behavior, what we saw here, was done by running an external ASP.NET IIS application, which can be running in Windows Azure, can be running in local IIS boxes and so forth. So it brings us more agile and more reliable SharePoint deployments as well. And using this pattern, as you can see, the cloud application model can be used also for branding behavior for the private and public My Sites, obviously, as well. So this is this has been kind of a classic challenge, how you can personalize a personal My Sites into Office 365. And there's your answer. Hopefully the demo was interesting and the code is downloadable in the blog post as well. So feel free to actually figure out and modify the code any way you want. It's all for you to be used. This is not, however, meant to be deployed directly to the production. It's just a proof of concept code. So please make sure that you test it carefully within your deployment as well. But the whole point, again, cloud application model can be actually pretty powerful. No customizations in a SharePoint, and we're still able to apply interesting changes to our SharePoint form.